Hi, Pastor Cindy here with our midweek break, a very brief midweek break. This is what I woke up to this morning. My decorating is not complete yet and won't be until I'm able to clean up this mess. Now, what you see might look like a mess, but actually it makes me smile. This is a mess caused by a dog who grew up on the streets, was a rescue, a stray, whose idea of safety weathering a storm was burrowing under a bush outside and had to be convinced that hiding behind the sofa might be a better alternative. Her first few weeks in foster care were spent getting treated for heartworm. So toys were strange to her, and it took a long time for her to be comfortable enough to play with one. But with loving patience and consistency, she has become a wiggly, tail-thumping, nuzzling, attention-loving girl. And she's become quite precise in the way that she tears apart a toy, not only playing with it, but conquering it. As you can see, it takes a surgical-like incision in this toy to then extract the squeaker, which she then lays aside for my dog, Kate, to have and to destroy. So, you know, you gotta have give her a lot of credit for how far she has come in her short life. So where in your life do you have messes that are actually an indication that people can change? I think about the issues that we face today, all of the isms that we're fighting on a daily basis. And I pray that the fact that we're fighting them is an indication that indeed people can and do change. God loves us the way we are, but refuses to leave us that way. Advent is a time of waiting, but behind the waiting, there's hope. And it's not the hope of optimism in disguise, but it's hope based on the reality of our faithful God, who continues to find new ways to reach us, to save us, to help us have the courage to consider what it might mean to change some things in our lives. Maybe we do that for the benefit of others, and maybe in the long run, it also benefits us. This Sunday, we'll participate in that call to courage as we join our Savior, Jesus Christ, in Holy Communion. We will consecrate the bread and the juice in our live stream service at 10:30. And then we invite you to come to the church to drive through the portico where the pastors will be there to greet you and to serve you as we join in this time together. I hope you have a great week. I hope the messes of life don't throw you for a loop, but I hope you're able to see them for what they are, as the indication that redemption is possible and that change is sometimes a good thing and an indication that God still loves us and is still at work in our lives. Amen, and have a great week.